っても日が抱き抱いて照らしめて魂燃やついれるて見つけ出すいつか同じ手たりに今出会えた仲間たちよ我はを夢に我なりあんたの時のきしみこびたす仲間たちよ我はを夢に我なり人生は誰も皆一の切るさ思いもの前に仕掛けるかが船ぬのは君は強く見つめるから命が赤くなるのさ意味らぬにたきあらが必要よ君はついてからえみこもういいんだだからせめていつけるおやついでみて見つけてすくよアモレロボカレよおなじでたりに今出会えた仲間たちよ我はを夢に我なりあんたの地域のきしみこぴたす仲間たちよ我はを夢に我なりおなじでたりに今出会えた仲間たちよ我はを夢に我なり肌の地域のきしみこびたす仲間たちよ我はを夢に我なり人生は誰もみんな一の霧さ思いもの前に Nelly. Alrighty, here we go. As Ike is kicking all their asses right now. Oh, 224. Thanks to Roy. Roy, stop Ike. Here we go, Wario is going for a new record for himself, if he can, as he is riding a motorcycle. The key to winning this whole thing for Wario, or like to last longer with Wario, is that you should try to ride a motorcycle back and forth. It's not like they're gonna hit you, I think. Honestly, I don't think that they're gonna even hit you. I think they only hit you once in a while. So there's a high chance where you can still hit them with a motorcycle. So yeah. Yep. This is fun. Playing multi-mammy like this because it's survival, you know. It's just like you're playing zombies for, you know, it's like you're playing zombies for Call of Duty, Black Ops, or something like that. So it's pretty fun. Pretty cool. So, yeah. Oh, man. Tuesday Night Smash Bros. It's one of my favorite, thing I like to do. I just like to make that up. They brawl and brawl and brawl. Yeah. Well, who's ready for SmackDown? Not just that, also WrestleMania 33. It's gonna be in Orlando, Florida of this year on April 2nd, which is 2 weeks away. Because as of today, we all know what day today is, whatever the day this video is posted. But it's pretty cool. Can't wait for WrestleMania, old school versus new school, basically. The theme of this whole WrestleMania is old school versus new school, so, yeah. Pretty funny. Oh, man. Taker versus Roman Reigns. Kevin Owens versus Jericho. Shane McMahon versus AJ Styles. Seth Rollins versus Triple H, Bray Wyatt versus Randy Orton, what else? Tag teams don't count. Does Miz versus John Cena count? I don't know, because I mean, The Miz has been in WWE for like over almost 10 years now. Yeah, almost 10 years. Because I remember when he first joined WWE back then, it was so funny, hilarious, but it's pretty cool seeing him. What is that? What is it? Oh yeah, also, this is not really considered as old school versus new school, but I just think of two old guys going at it, which is Oldberg versus Brock Lesnar. The reason why I say Oldberg, because he's old, and honestly, I'm still pissed off. There's a lot of things I like to get off my chest about the freaking WWE, about this whole thing, because it's like, the whole concept of this, like, yeah, it would be cool just to see Goldberg versus Brock Lesnar for like 1 second at freaking WrestleMania, waste of our time, but it's like, the thing that bugs me, the most, the thing that bugs me about this whole thing, about their matchup, is that Kevin Owens was the Universal Champion, and he was the Universal Champion. He was awesome. I hate him as the character, but hey, you know what? It's for entertainment, right? And he did it for entertainment, and I liked it. When he did it, obviously everyone enjoyed it, because at least we get to see a full time champion on screen, off screen, live stages, or live events and stuff like that. And as for Oldberg, most likely he's doing the same thing what Brock Lesnar did back in 2014, which I'm still upset and pissed off about it, because I think it's just stupid how like a part-timer like freaking Brock Lesnar, who everyone cherished so much back then. I never really liked him, honestly. Brock Lesnar, I never really liked him back then. He was always that jerk and the asshole. And even though I would prefer old school Lesnar more, because he actually wrestled back then when he was younger, but ever since, you know, this whole concept thing of money issue, bullcrap, ticket selling and stuff, but more to the point is that freaking Goldberg randomly challenged, okay, the part where he challenges Kevin Owens for the belt. Yes, I understand that, because Goldberg is making a challenge, which makes total sense. I mean, yeah, he didn't deserve it, but then, like, he actually did, like, a UFC kind of thing, where, like, just like, oh, yeah, I'm gonna go challenge this guy next, because this is the guy that I've been planning to challenge all along. But then, turns out, it did really happen. Well, I mean, a lot of people didn't really like it, but hey, who am I to judge? Who am I to control? But the only thing that there's a lot of things. Why do I keep saying the only thing when there are so many things that irritates me so much about it? My God. Like for example, Goldberg, obviously he can't wrestle. This match with Kevin Owens lasted 11 minutes, because for a chunk of the freaking match, Kevin Owens went and walk around the ring, outside of the ring, for like 7-6 minutes of the match. And then the last 3 minutes, spent 3 more minutes walking around, and then spend the next two minutes or so preparing, and then BAM! Say, let's go, let's go. And then Chris Jericho's music hits and blah, blah, blah. Goldberg wins with just a spear and a stupid jackhammer, which I think is still stupid. I don't know, honestly. See, now think of it, it's like, originally, the match between freaking Goldberg or Oldberg and freaking Brock Lesnar was supposed to be just a normal freaking match. No one even says, and plus, not just that, like, the thing that bugs me a lot that I can't really ask myself or ask anyone or like try to clarify this to ask a question out of it is that what the hell did Brock Lesnar do to even deserve this title to get a title shot, even Goldberg like was holding, like even though Goldberg was holding it. Like, it's not like he deserves it. I know that Goldberg didn't deserve to even win to go for the belt. But then I think that's safe, because Goldberg made a call out to Kevin Owens. And as for freaking Brock Lesnar, who was being a little bitch and bitching about like losing to Goldberg back in Survivor Series and WrestleMania 22 back then. I honestly think it's just stupid. We're like, I don't know, guys. I just don't know what to say. Because it's just annoying. We're like, you originally had a match with a person who's not a champion. And that person became a champion, like, 3 weeks before your match at a pay-per-view. And also, no one even asked the question. I'm pretty sure Paul Heyman was confused, too. And plus, I'm pretty sure whoever asked Paul Heyman about the questions about, so if Goldberg becomes champion, what does that leave Brock Lesnar? And Paul Heyman couldn't even explain why is it that Brock Lesnar deserves to even get a shot at the belt, when clearly there's no need to get a shot for the belt. Like, seriously, I think it's just stupid. Really stupid. God.